Welcome back to another episode of 40 Facts About the 40K Universe. I am your host, Kirsch One, and you are watching One Mind Syndicate. Today we continue talking about Space Marines versus Orcs as we get into the invasion of Rhine's world. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. We post Warhammer 40K lore videos every single day. Don't forget to hit the little bell notification icon to stay updated. And if you enjoy our content, thank our patrons on Patreon. It's because of them that we can do this. The Patreon funds go towards a giveaway. And don't forget that right now, we have a giveaway for Mortarion. You can win the Demon Primarch Mortarion if you check out our 40 facts on how the traitor Primarchs became demons. Link above or in the description. But with that said, let's get into 40 facts on Rhine's world. Following the end of the Horus Heresy and the subsequent period of retribution known as the Great Scouring, Gilliman, Primarch of the Ultramarines Legion, penned his Codex Astarte. With its creation, the Primarch demanded that his brothers accept his example by dividing their own legions into 1,000-member Space Marine chapters. Initially, Rogaldorn, Primarch of the Imperial Fist Legion, opposed the notion. He felt strongly that it was even more crucial for his Space Marines to remain consolidated so that they could continue to work closely together so that they could protect the Imperium from the remnants of the traitor legions. But eventually Dorn conceded, and so he divided his legion. Two of the chapters formed from the Imperial Fists were the Black Templars and the Crimson Fists. Dorn selected the Crimson Fist members from those who were recently initiated into the Legion, with the exception of its leaders. The newly founded chapter's first chapter master was Alexis Pollux, captain of the 405th Company, and a stalwart battle brother who had won the Primarch's respect countless times. Known as much for his massive physical size and prowess as his leadership and tactical expertise, Pollux led the Crimson Fists for the first 800 years of their existence. During this time, he did much to shape their interpretation of the Codex Astarte and their combat doctrines. For the first 9 millennia of their existence, the Crimson Fist chapter traveled throughout the Imperium as a crusading chapter. The battle barge Rutilus Tyrannus was their home amongst the stars, though additional strike cruisers supported it. Across these ages, the Crimson Fist built a reputation of loyal service and utter competency against any who would oppose the Imperium. Much of their activity was focused within the Loki sector of the Segmentum Tempestus, but this was not the only region of the galaxy in which they defended the Imperium. Through their long service, the Crimson Fist have often answered the calls of the Inquisition as well as the Adeptus Administratum. No matter the nature of the foe, these battle brothers remain loyal to the Imperium and its sacred cause. With the success of the Voltigeran Crusade, the High Lords of Terror rewarded the Crimson Fist by granting them full feudal rights to the feudal agri-world known as Rhine's World within the Loki sector. The Crimson Fist soon constructed their fortress monastery, the Arx Tyrannis, from the remains of the great vessels that had long served as their mobile headquarters while they were a fleet-based chapter. Over the course of this crusade, the chapter blunted countless significant orc forces within the sector, preventing them from unifying into a single, overwhelming threat. The proximity of Rhine's world to one of the Crimson Fist's primary recruiting worlds was ideal, and the chapter constructed their fortress monastery in the middle of the inhospitable and frigid Hellblade Mountains of the planet's southern continent. The planet's capital is New Rhine City, home to nearly 6 million of the planet's 200 million people. The next largest city on the world has only 3 million people at most, and the majority of the world's population serves as indentured servants working on tens of thousands of agricultural communes that work the lands of the three continents. These communes were owned by the Rhinite noble class, and the planetary administration was divided into 9 provinces, each of which was controlled by a single noble clan, ultimately reporting to the most powerful noble family, House Cagliostro. As the Crimson Fists take little direct involvement with the human population on Rhine's world, the Cagliostros have been granted the right by the chapter to administer the fiefdom in the chapter master's place, and serve as Rhine's world's planetary governors through a hereditary succession. The Astartes had granted this right to the native nobility that had ruled over the world in the days before the Crimson Fists had been granted the fiefdom, so that they could concentrate their energies upon preparing for war and prosecuting campaigns against the Emperor's foes. As Rhine's world is lightly populated, for the most part, it has been given over to intensive agriculture. The planet's primary exports have historically been particularly exotic food, which becomes renowned delicacies amongst the imperial nobility of the sector. Though Ryan's world is the Crimson Fist home, it is not a world from which they actively recruit. During their millennia as a crusading chapter, the Crimson Fist established practices of recruitment on many worlds in the Loki sector. While a few have significant technological bases, the chapter has generally recruited preferably from feral worlds. However, they never sought out those who engaged in savagery for its own sake. Rather, the most appropriate candidates were characterized by a combination of honor, athleticism, and stoicism in the face of overwhelming odds. Since constructing of their fortress monastery, the Crimson Fist have focused their recruitment to Blackwater, which is relatively close to Ryan's world. While aspirants are sometimes taken from other worlds, this practice has become increasingly uncommon. Ryan's world is the third planet of the Rhinestar system, a solar system that circles the binary stars, Rhinestar and Eloix, in the Loki sector of the galaxy, to the galactic southeast of Terra in the Segmentum Tempestus, near the borders of the Segmentum Ultima. It is circled by two moons, Dantine and Eloix. The world is largely isolated from other human-inhabited planets, but the Crimson Fist presence has led to the implantation of extensive planetary defense systems. Furthermore, the chapter's actions during the Voltigeran Crusade migrated the Orc presence within the sector. There is a considerable warp space between Rhinestar's system and its nearest human neighbors. Unfortunately for Ryan's world, it was not far through the warp space from the border of the Orc Empire of Caradon. In the late 41st millennium, the Orc warlord, Snaggrod, the Orc arsonists of Caradon, united the warring greenskin factions bordering the Loki sector and launched the largest war the Imperium Cluster has seen since the Great Crusade, attacking the isolated Imperial agri-world of Bad Landing. The Imperial defenders of Bad Landing were utterly unprepared for the invasion, and within days, the only major strong point of resistance was the capital city of Krugerport, where the remnants of the 18th Mordian, the 24th Llamas, and the 49th Boros Imperial Guard Regiment, commanded by Commissar Baldur, put up a bold but ultimately doomed defense. Confident that he had the world in his grasp, Snaggrock put out a ranting broadcast boasting that his next conquest would be Ryan's world, which lay only a few weeks of warp travel from Bad Landing. Chapter Master Pedro Contor responded immediately, dispatching the 3rd Company under Captain Ashur Draken to Bad Landing to stall the Orc Wall and determine its strength. The Battle of Krugerport was a tragic defeat for the Crimson Fist, who found Wall Snaggrock to be far larger and more aggressive than anything they had predicted. In the resulting defeat, the Crimson Fist suffered a loss of 56 Space Marines out of a detachment of 84. Captain Draken was among the fallen. The handful of Space Marines that survived the battle were able to escape to bring valuable intelligence back to Ryan's world. Upon hearing of the size and strength of the Orc War Host, Chapter Master Cantor ordered the immediate recall of the chapter's companies fighting away from Ryan's world, mobilizing the Planetary Defense Force, and preparing for an inevitable invasion. When Wah Snaggrock hit Ryan's world, it was a force unparalleled by any Orc invasion since those of the Hive World of Armageddon. As the world dropships and the rocks fell through the night skies, the chapter's defense systems responded. All was well until a malfunctioning plasma missile from a Space Marine surface-to-space defense system, in a trillion-to-one malfunction, impacted the Crimson Fist Fortress Monastery. The errant missile scored an impressively accurate, if altogether unintentional, hit on the Fortress Monastery's main armory. The arsenal, the Fortress Monastery of the Crimson Fist, the mountain, and an area half a mile wide were instantly atomized. The chapter was almost obliterated in the ensuing holocaust. Only 16 Crimson Fist garrison in the Fortress Monastery survived, including Chapter Master Pedro Contor and Captain Alessio Cortez. The surviving Crimson Fist stayed in New Rhine City, held out against the Orc siege. The siege of New Rhine City was to be a grinding 18 solar months, but the Crimson Fist were able to maintain their defenses until an Imperial Navy Liberation Fleet, including elements from 6 other Space Marine chapters, finally arrived 18 solar months after the invasion began. The Imperial reinforcement drove the Orcs from the world. The Orc invasion of Rhine's world proved to be costly. All of the planet's major cities were destroyed, with the exception of New Rhine City. Millions of the agri-world's people had been killed, most likely the majority of the population. It would take solar decades for the planet to recover its lost infrastructure and agricultural productivity. Many of the worlds of the Loki sector, captured by Wasnagrok, including Bad Landing, were lost, remaining in Orc hands to this day. Early in the 42nd millennium, the birth of the Great Rift engulfed Rhine's world with demonic legions spilling forth from the newly formed portal. The demons were led by Demon Prince Raxor, and the Crimson Fist were forced to battle for their homeworld survival once more, though they had little chance of success with such a depleted rank. The arrival of Primarch Gilliman's Indominus Crusade managed to break the siege and also integrate the Primaris Space Marines into the Crimson Fist. The chapter found all its losses it had suffered at the hands of the Orcs made up by these additional Primaris Astartes. And those were 40 facts on the invasion of Rhine's world. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, share it with your friends and thank our patrons on Patreon. It's because of them that we can do these videos. Link in the description if you guys want to support us. It's $1 a month and it helps us do giveaways. Speaking about giveaways, let's announce the winners. Are the winner of last week's No Fear box set giveaway, subscriber appreciation giveaway thing. So that winner is this guy. Simply contact us either on Facebook, Instagram, or here on YouTube. Let us know that you won. Give us your address, and we'll ship this guy to you. If you didn't win, don't worry. Don't forget that there is another Mortarion giveaway going on right now in yesterday's video. Link above, probably again, if not in the descriptions. But thanks for everything, guys, and I will talk to you tomorrow. This is Gersh One with One Mind Syndicate signing out. Oh, if you could put my freedom first in any situation.